Welcome everybody to this amazing interview that we are going to have with Dr. Jimmy Gutman, my good friend, Dr. Jimmy Gutman. And I am Gian-Carlo, your friend. And I'm super excited because today we're going to talk about glutathione and neurodegenerative disease. Who better than Dr. Jimmy Gutman, who is the world-renowned expert on glutathione. You know, we're all really excited to really find out the connection between glutathione and the brain. So let's start with that, Dr. Gutman. What is meant by neurodegenerative disease?
When you look at the word itself, when you see the term neuro, we know that we're going to be talking about neurology or the study of nerves or the nervous system. Now, when we look at the nervous system, there are actually three large parts to the nervous system. The peripheral nerves that serves our arms and our legs and our skin and so on. The spine, which houses that main trunk of wires coming out of the skull. And finally, the brain, which I think most scientists agree is probably the most sophisticated structure in the known universe.
There's the second part of that word.
Neurodegenerative. Well, we usually use the word degenerative. It implies a kind of a slow or chronic breakdown in structure or function. So most of these are considered chronic diseases, which tend to unfortunately deteriorate over time. Now, fortunately, the peripheral nerves are pretty tough. They don't show up so often on the list of neurodegenerative problems. The spine, a little less so. But the brain, being the most complicated, is the most prone to developing problems.
Now we can ask the third question. What are some common diseases we have heard of?
Yeah, I'm sure that everybody in this call has heard of Parkinson's and Alzheimer's disease. And I'm also sure that many of our listeners today have been directly affected in one way or another with one of or both of these two problems. It's unfortunately all too common. And both of these Parkinson's and Alzheimer's tend to be progressive over the years, some cases deteriorating faster than others.
When we talk about Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease, Dr. Gutman, we generally think of older people. Now, I'm quite sure neurodegenerative disease strikes a younger population as well. Can you give us some examples, please?
There's too many. One that needs to be mentioned is MS, or multiple sclerosis. Usually this affects people who could be starting in their teens or 20s, occasionally later. What's remarkable about MS is that it can affect any part of the nervous system, not just the brain. And that makes the initial diagnosis tricky at the early stages. You know, the patient will present with anything from a weak vision in one eye to problems urinating to a weak leg. You know, the diagnosis is often delayed until there are several different attacks. And when you see different attacks from different places in the neurological system, then the suspicion of MS definitely goes up. Another neurological problem that we see in young adults is what's called motor neuron disease. Give you an example, the famous scientist Stephen Hawking is an example. You know, you've all seen him. He's got motor neuron disease. A related problem is ALS, which stands for amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. This was made notorious by the baseball player Lou Gehrig. In fact, people refer to this problem as Lou Gehrig's disease. Then there's things like Huntington's diseases. Again, right through the spectrum from the very young to the very old, there are far too many examples of neurodegenerative diseases.
As we spoke, you know, I know there's one neurodegenerative disease that you haven't mentioned. Just to jar your memory, it seems to affect even a younger age group.
You got me there, GC. Of course. Autism, this is considered a neurodegenerative disease. And we've all been hearing a lot about this. And I know y'all want to talk more about it, but I promise you, I will be talking even more about autism in due time. It's a whole other subject.
Now, Dr. Gutman, we're talking about all these brain problems, these diseases that we can get, for many reasons. But as we said in the beginning, we spoke about that we were going to talk about glutathione. So how does glutathione play with neurodegenerative disease?
Well, that's the crazy thing about all of this. In my last book on glutathione, I had dedicated a whole new section to glutathione and the brain. And in there are multiple chapters covering different neurodegenerative diseases. And here's the thing, each and every one of these are related to a drop in glutathione. Each and every one. It still remains to be worked out whether this is a chicken or egg phenomenon. But what's more important is that there has been so much research done here, and a lot of it is suggesting that raising glutathione may play a key role in prevention or even treatment. You all need to look at these studies.
Can you just recap some of the studies already done on the field, done using Immunocan? Now, for the ones that are watching this for the first time, you heard about glutathione and you heard about what we're talking about, obviously, but you haven't heard about Immunocal. So, Dr. Gutman, please talk a little bit about Immunocal and the studies done with Immunocal in this role.
To give you 30 seconds on Immunocal is a natural protein product that was developed over 40 years ago. And this natural protein, when you eat it, does guess what? Raises glutathione. And so we discovered this at McGill University. And of course, it was a research group. So we did research long before it was a commercial product. So we've done research on Immunocal and human beings for a long time. And so the question is, what have we done using Immunocal to raise glutathione in neurodegenerative diseases? Well, we've mentioned one before. Our most recent one would have been in autism. But let's go back a bit. This neurodegenerative research, this represents some of our best work. We've touched upon Alzheimer's and Parkinson's, schizophrenia, ALS, and more. Let me read the title of a paper written by
Please.
probably our most prolific neuroscientist using Immunocal, one Dr. Daniel Linsman. He's out of University of Denver. And listen to this title, it's self-explanatory. Immunocal and the preservation of glutathione as a novel neuroprotective strategy for degenerative disorders of the nervous system. How do you have a more direct and specific title that summarizes it better than that? And you guys can you can get a hold of that paper, right? I know that Gian-Carlo, I can give you a link to downloading all of our 85 published studies. I just put out a new edition of that book recently, so it's available. All the abstracts, 85 abstracts.
You know, what you just read gave me goosebumps.
Really? Me too. Every time I read it.
Dr. Gumman, I remember the first time I had even seen the importance on this topic. It was an article that you did for Immunotech. And in the end, you said, just like a real estate agent says, location, 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 supplements, it has to be research, research, research. I've used that hundreds of times. But that was the first time that I saw the importance of research, especially with supplements. So thank you so much for really explaining about that. And for the ones that are watching, please take notes. This is gold. And now, Dr. Gutman, the last question, the big question, the million-dollar question. What is the next big study that Immunotech is working on brain disease?
Well, it's good that you asked. And I know It sounds like I said a few frightening things before, but I can say another frightening one now. There's a new neurodegenerative disease that has only recently been described compared to the others that we talked about, like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. For me, this is the one that most of us already fear the most, even though we don't know the name, because so many of us, my age anyways, are already experiencing some of the symptoms. And you don't may not know the name. Well, let me tell you the name. It's called MCI, or mild cognitive impairment. It's a new diagnosis. What is MCI? Well, let me give you an example or two. You know, when an older person keeps on losing their keys or misplaces their glasses, when they can't remember names or they get lost driving on roads that should be familiar to them, these can be, not necessarily, but these can be signs of mild cognitive impairment. And mild cognitive impairment is a major risk factor for the subsequent development of Alzheimer's. So the key here is jumping on this as early as possible to do what you can to avoid this neurodegeneration. You don't want to get into the degenerative form. You want to keep it as stable as possible. So in science, our improving ability to look into the brain real time has allowed us to see and determine things about the brain we never had access to, but now we do. Here's something that most people are blown away from when they hear about this. We can now determine glutathione levels in a living brain using a specially tuned MRI scanner. Could you imagine? You know, put somebody into the scanner and look at the glutathione levels in their brain. And guess what? Of course, we're taking full advantage of this technology, be sure. And we're already well underway with a study at McGill University in Montreal, Canada. Again, there's a lot of Americans there. I'll tell you, McGill University is the Harvard of Canada. Looking at the effect of Immunical. Yeah, Immunical on this very problem. So be proud, folks. People use that term all too often, cutting edge. We're cutting edge.
Well, Dr. Gutman, the info that you have really spoken about has truly been gold, better than gold, because we all need this. We all need to hear about this, because if we know this, we can help a lot more people with it. And that is the goal of these interviews. And for the ones that are watching, if you still don't have this book, and I'm pitching for you again, Dr. Gutman. I need royalties for this. No, just kidding. He has his latest book, The Comprehensive Guide to Glutathione. Everything that you want to know about glutathione is in this book. If you go to Amazon.com or if you go to glutathione.org, you can get this book and you can find many of the things that Dr. Gutman just shared today. So Dr. Gutman, again, my friend, it's always great. It's always better. And it's always better because you always have good info and new info to share with us. So my friend, thank you so much.
Thank you, GC. It's always a pleasure to work with you.